In this video, we are going to create a cell grid system that will open a cell position when the next cell price is reached. So let's speed that up a little bit. And you see that we have several positions. So let's find out how to create something like this with MQL5. To do that, please click on the little icon here or press F4 on your keyboard. Now you should see the Metaeditor window, and here you want to click on File, New File, Expert Advisor from Template, Continue. I will call this file Simple Cell Grid System, click on Continue, Continue and Finish. Now you can delete everything above the Ontick function. And let's also remove the two command lines. We start with an include function to include the file trade.mqh. This one will enable us to create an instance of the class Ctrade. It gives us simplified trading functions, and it will be called trade. We also want to create an array for the price data that is called priceInfo, and it is created by using MQL rates. And let's create a string variable for the signal that is also called signal, but we don't assign a value here because we are going to calculate that later. Inside of the onTick function, we want to start by creating a static double variable for the next cell price. Static is a modifier that will remain the value for as long as the expert advisor is running, even if we leave the function. Now let's calculate the bid price. That is done by using symbol info double for the current symbol on the chart. We are using symbol underscore bid, and with normalized double and underscore digits, we make sure that we automatically calculate the right number of digits behind the dot, because some currency pairs have 5 digits behind the dot and the other ones have 3 digits behind the dot. Now let's use array set as series for the price info array to sort the current array from the current candle downwards. And with copy rates, we can now fill the array with data for the current symbol on the chart and the currently selected period on that chart, starting from candle 0 for 3 candles. We store the data in the price info array, and we can also use underscores here, like we did in this line. Now, if we have no open positions, that would be true when positions total has a value of 0. We want to set our next cell price to 0. That is a reset. Afterwards, we want to check our entry signal by calling a function that is called checkEntrySignal. That function doesn't exist so far, so we need to create it in a few minutes. But before we do that, we want to check if the bid price currently is below the next cell price or if the next cell price equals 0. If that is the case, we want to open a cell position. That is done by using trade.sell for 10 micro lot. And right after we have done that, we want to set the next cell price 50 points below the current cell price level. Let's also add a command statement to create an output for the bid price and for the next cell price right on our chart. So far, so good. That's the onTick function. But now we need to create this function here. It is called checkEntrySignal, and it will return a string value, because when the close price for the last candle in our price info array is above the open price for candle 1 in our price info array, we consider that to be a buy signal. So now we assign the word buy to our signal. Otherwise, when the close price for candle 1 in our price info array is bigger than the open price for candle 1 in our price info array, that would be a sell signal, and now we assign the word sell to our signal. Finally, we want to return our signal to the main module and close this function. And that's about it. If this was too fast for you, or if you have no idea what all the code here does, Maybe you want to watch one of the other basic videos in this video series. And on our website you can now find a link for all these videos, including the source codes in our shop. For now, let's enable the toolbar and click on compile or press F7. You shouldn't get any errors, and if that is the case, you can click on a little button here or press F4 to go back to MetaTrader. And in MetaTrader, you want to click on View, Strategy Tester, or press Ctrl and R. Please pick the new file simplecellgridsystem.ex5. Mark the option for the visual mode. If you don't see that, it is below here, and start a test. Now you should see the first cell trade is opened. Here is the second one. And every 50 points, we will see a new cell trade. So our little cell grid system works as expected. And you have coded it yourself with a few lines of MQL5 code.